Well, first of all, just how excited are you to get this new season underway?
Yeah, so excited. Season's the best part of the year. You know, we've trained for the past 8 months for this opportunity, and everyone's excited and everyone's ready to go.
In terms of you had a busy offseason competing with the national team. How has that experience helped prepare you to lead this group of Gamecocks this year?
Yeah, I mean, training with the national team is always a great honor, and it's always a good environment to be in. It's so competitive whenever you step on the field, just because everyone there is amazing soccer players. So that experience and that environment that I've been able to train in, I can bring it back here and raise the level here and, you know, just bring in everything that I've learned into this environment and hopefully make our team better.
What did you learn?
I mean, it's just like little tactical things. Like speed of play is a whole other level there. Especially like international play. So whenever you're playing other countries, it's just so much faster and so much more physical. And the other countries, people have been playing professional since they were 18 years old because they don't really go to college. They just go straight to professional. So you're playing against professionals that have been professionals for 3 to 5 years. So just that environment and that experience was a big thing for me to like get used to and learn from.
Your coach talked about your left foot. That's a shot you have now that you learned this summer. What other things did you learn on the field about your game that improved your game, you think?
Yeah, it was mainly just for me learning, you know, where my weaknesses are or my lesser strengths. And so working on those and getting better to, like, make my overall game better was a big thing for me this summer and in the offseason. So I really just focused on those little things technically to get better and hopefully, you know, raise my game for this season.
What does it say about this program that you're ranked number 4 despite the fact that you guys lost so much senior power from last year's team, but you're still considered to be one of the more dominant programs going into this season?
Yeah, I mean, we have a great group of returners that are coming back. Some of the freshmen last year that are now sophomores are going to give us great minutes this year, and then we have a great senior class, and I think that leadership is going to help the freshmen coming in raise their game. And I mean, the talent out of the freshman class is unreal, some of the best that we've had in a long time. So I think they're going to give us valuable minutes going forward, and I just overall this team is coming together really nicely, and the chemistry is great, and I think, you know, we deserve that fourth place overall.
You broke pretty much every school record last year for scoring and all sorts of stuff. How do you, what are your goals for this year? How do you top that?
Yeah, I mean, last year I really didn't focus on any of that. I kind of just played my game and helped the team win games, and that was kind of my main focus. So I think that's not going to change for this season. My team goals are still the same. You know, I want to win another SEC championship. I want to make it farther in the NCAAs, and I think by me focusing on the team goals is going to just raise my game to the next level. And then if I break records, so be it. You know, that's always a great thing to have along the way, but that's definitely not something that I'm going to keep focusing on.
Having that experience last year with you guys winning and having so much success, how does that help with a new team and setting the standard and your voice as a leader last year, and you can utilize that kind of voice and experience from last year to help this team live up to the big expectations?
Yeah, I mean, just the past 3 years, we've, you know, gone to the Elite Eight twice and then won the SEC, and I think that experience is just going to help this team move along. That we've done that, but that's in the past. We have to continue to prove ourselves, and I think the senior class really understands that and really wants to leave this program better than we found it. So that experience we're just going to pass down to the freshmen and show them our expectations for the season.
National championship within reach this year?
Absolutely. That's always the goal. You know, we've gone to the Elite Eight twice, and we really want to break through that wall and get to the Final Four. And I think if we get there, we're going to have a really good shot to win the whole thing.
By making the national team this summer, does that set you up for the Olympics and the World Championship or the World Cup?
I was with the U23s mainly for this past 7 months. So I was in with the full team for like 4 or 5 days, but the full team is what goes to the Olympics and stuff. So that's kind of, you know, always the end goal. So you kind of just have to wait for your call up again and hope that whenever you do get called in, then you just have to do whatever you can to earn a spot on that roster. And the qualifying will be next year, and then for the World Cup, and then the World Cup's 2019, and then the Olympics are 2020. So, I mean, that's obviously the goal for everyone, but just kind of have to wait for the chance.
Looking back on your career, how did a girl from just up the road in Chapin, South Carolina, become one of the best soccer players in the world?
I don't know, a lot of hard work. You know, it was always, I remember when I was, you know, 7 or 8 years old, and I said that I was going to play D1 soccer and I was going to make the national team, and that those goals haven't changed. So everything along the way, from the extra workouts that I've done outside of practice, or, you know, getting up at 6 a.m. when I was in high school to go work out before school, anything like that, I think has really gotten me to where I am now. And just the mindset of always doing everything to reach your goals has always had to be something in my sights and in the front of my mind, because once you deviate from that, then your mind's on something else. So it's just really that drive and that focus that I've always had to get to where I am was a big thing.
When did you start the 6 a.m. workouts? When you were in high school, junior, senior, or?
No, actually, when I was 7th or 8th grade. Wow. Yeah, so it's been a long time, and I've always kind of wanted to get to where I am now and get farther than where I am now, and just the drive that I've been able to, you know, keep up and have has really gotten me to where I am.
Who was your motivation to do this? Did you have a mentor? Were your parents, somebody else, a coach? Who kind of drove you?
I think my drive and my work ethic and hard work that I bring to everything I do is from my parents for sure. I mean, my dad owns his own business now. My mom's a principal of an elementary school, and everything that I see them do is like they give it all their all. So just that learning that from a young age and finding out what I wanted to do, I was able to learn my, you know, goals and dreams at a very young age, and that didn't ever change. So just to be able to continue to work at that and really focus on that for a long time now was a big thing. And I mean, definitely them, because I see them continue to work hard for everything they do every single day. So
how many days a week would you get up at 6 a.m. and go work out?
Yeah, I mean, usually Monday through Friday was my big workload, just because of, you know, I was still playing club soccer, so, you know, Saturdays were game days, so it was mostly Monday through Friday.
And you did that all the way through school and the summer, club soccer and everything?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for the most part, yeah. That was kind of the only time that I had during the day to do it, so, you know, I just sucked it up and got up and then went to school and usually had practice. When I was in high school, I drove up to Greenville at CESA to train, so, you know, driving up there in the afternoons was kind of the afternoon time, so I didn't really have time to do that.
Yeah. And all of that was chasing this dream to play here and the national team.
Absolutely. You got to do what you got to do sometimes.
That's great.
So as busy as you've been, as hard as you've worked for it all, were you able to enjoy being with the U23 team and soak in moments? What stood out?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the first camp is kind of like, okay, I have to go prove myself. I have to go make a name for myself. And then, you know, I got called in with the full team, which really I didn't get to process at the time. It was kind of like, okay, you're going with the full team tomorrow. Oh, okay. Okay. All right. So then, you know, you just go in and work hard again. And then after that is when I kind of got to look back and be like, okay, that was cool. I want to keep getting back there. So then whenever I got to go to Spain and wear the United States jersey out of the country for the first time, and I started and was the captain for the first game and against Japan, that was a surreal moment, walking out to our national anthem and all of that. So, I mean, that's just a whole other honor that every time you put the crest on, it's just an amazing feeling, and that feeling never really goes away. So definitely enjoy it along the way, just because you have to. You have no choice.
And you scored in that game, didn't you? Didn't you score the first goal?
I did, yeah. Yep, that was my first cap with the 23s, and I scored a goal. So that was a great, great time. And Japan's a phenomenal team, so it was a lot of fun.
And what was that moment like to score?
It was surreal. It was awesome. I mean, first game, first goal, it was, you know, amazing. And then to go on and win that game against a really great team like Japan really just, you know, helped our team for that whole tournament.